Paint, brushes, models, there are several things that are an obvious part of the hobby. But that's not everything. Here are 5 hobby tools you didn't know you needed. This video is sponsored by Crippled God Foundry. Squeeze bottle. This squeeze bottle has been a game changer for cleaning my airbrush. Depending on how long you work for and how much paint you place in the cup, paint can begin to dry or stain the inside of your cup. If left uncleaned, this paint can mix in and tint your newly added paint. When I'm ready to change paint, I hang the airbrush over the side of a cup, squirt the bottle into the cup of the airbrush, and use an old brush to remove my old color. Since we don't want to push that dirty paint water through the gun, I squirt the water until it runs clean from the cup. Then I go about my normal cleaning routine. Secondly, I use the squeeze bottle for my wet palette. For the best painting experience, we need to keep our wet palette in peak condition. Whenever my palette starts getting a little dry, I can easily squirt this into the side of my wet palette whenever I need to rehydrate the sponge while disturbing the paint and paper as little as possible.
Hi. Hi. Hello. Hi. It's a paintbrush and a model, like always. What? What is it? Hi!
If you want to make it even easier, cut your paper a little smaller before you set up your palette for even easier access to the sponge. Silly Putty. Silly Putty is a great solution to mask off areas when airbrushing. In the past, I have recommended Blue Poster Tack. While Blue Poster Tack is still great for many things, Silly Putty is far superior when it comes to airbrush masking. I never worry about it pulling apart, getting trapped in the recesses, or leaving any residue behind. And besides, Silly Putty is just really fun. As for longevity, I'm not quite sure. I've been using the same Blue Poster Tack for years, using it over and over, getting it covered in paint, and it's still going. But I haven't put Silly Putty through as many paces, so I'll get back to you on what I think later. Saran Wrap. When I paint models that are too big for my grip, or maybe I just feel like holding the model with my hands will make painting easier, I use Saran Wrap to grip my model. Touching your model with bare hands can have negative side effects on your paint job. The oils from your fingers can cause paint to rub off, or maybe not stick at all. Saran Wrap is cheap, easily accessible, and can be used over and over. I wrap my model in Saran Wrap, leaving only the area I want to paint exposed, and hold the model however I need. I can rest my hand on the model, hold it whichever way I want, and feel confident in my ability to paint to the best of my ability in comfort. This week I'm painting this Bear Riding Dwarf from Cripple God Foundry's January set, Mountain War Stoneheart Clan. The set features 16 unique battle-ready dwarven miniatures, along with dwarven-inspired modular terrain and a bust of the Mountain King himself. Each miniature is gorgeously sculpted and comes pre-supported. The set also comes with D&D 5e lore and stat blocks to allow you to drop any of these pieces into your world with ease. If you like any of these models or want to get access to future releases, check out Crippled God Foundry's Patreon page or check out their tribe and my mini factory, link in my description box. Alright, back to the video. Sand timer. My number one mistake as a painter is not giving my paint enough time to dry in between coats. I work rather fast, especially in small areas, and I tend to want to layer up paint before I really should. Attempting to apply new layers over yet dry paint can cause texture by pulling up the dried areas of paint. I have found the best way to combat this has been to use a sand timer. The one I use personally is the 30-second timer, but perhaps the 1 minute or even longer will serve your needs. It's a great visual reminder to wait for my paint to dry without having to access technology or deal with distracting alarms. I wish I didn't need to buy a whole pack of these, but for me and the amount of time I paint, it is worth it. Trimmed brushes. This is a weird one, but one I swear by. Create your own undo brush by trimming an old brush down to mere millimeters of brush hair. With this derpy-looking tool, you now have a brush made to quickly remove any mistakes you might make. Before you can begin, you first need to seal your model. Consider the sealant like a Save As button. Anything under the sealant will become more difficult to remove. Note that I said more difficult, not impossible. After your model is sealed, continue painting. If you mess it up, dampen your trimmed brush and lightly scrub away your wayward paint. You want to work quickly. The longer the paint sits, the harder it will be to remove. But be cautious. If you scrub too hard, you could begin to remove the sealant and thus the paint underneath. I usually end up sealing my model several times. Anytime I'm happy with something and worried about the next step, take a moment and seal it just in case. All right, that's it from me. If you have any products you would like to recommend that I didn't list here and you think other people should know about, please let me know down in the comments. And thanks to Dicey D Hobbies for helping me print this model. You know the drill. Like, comment, subscribe, Patreon. I'll see you next time.